Greetings, deeply loved children of God. Welcome to Story Time with Pastor Maureen. I am Pastor Maureen Howard of Emmanuel Lutheran Church in Washington, Iowa, and I greet you with great joy because you choose to come and listen to the wonderful stories of Jesus that tell us how much we are loved, we are wanted, we are worthy, we are precious, we are chosen, we are loved by God. And so we find these stories in the Bible. And the Bible that we've been reading is the Spark Story Bible, which is published by Augsburg Fortress. And the stories that we're reading about God are from the Old Testament or the Hebrew Bible. And yesterday, we heard about the story of young boy David and how he was victorious over the big, mighty warrior Goliath. Well, today's story, David is an adult. He's no longer a little boy, and he's also a daddy. And he's a daddy to a man named Solomon. So David right now has gone from a little boy to an old man with his son Solomon. And so the story today is about Solomon. And it's called Solomon Builds a Temple. So are you ready for this wonderful story? Terrific. Well, let's begin. Solomon builds a temple. David was a great king for God's people. God told David that his son, Solomon, would build a temple. When Solomon became the king, he wanted to build a temple so God could live there. He wanted the temple to be the most dazzling, amazing building ever built. Solomon decided he would build the temple out of beautiful and expensive material. First, Solomon told his workers to dig large stones out of the ground. "I don't want God to hear any loud building noises here," Solomon told the workers. "You need to measure, cut, and shape the stones out in the hills before you bring them here." The workers did what Solomon told them to do. Next, Solomon told his workers to make the roof and the floor out of a hard, sturdy wood called cedar. And here's the picture of, well, let's go this way. Here's the picture of King Solomon telling his workers how to build the temple, the place where God will live, the place where people will go and worship God. And you can see these big, heavy stones are being dug and cut and measured to build the temple. And so can you find squiggles? Do you see squiggles? There, look, squiggles is helping the worker dig that stone out of the ground. And look how hard Squiggles is working. Carved designs of flowers into the cedar wood and decorate the temple with carvings, Solomon directed. The nice smell and elegant designs will make God happy. The workers did what Solomon told them to do. Finally, Solomon made a room especially for God. "Cover the entire room in gold," he said. The workers did what Solomon told them to do. The room glowed and shimmered. When the temple was finished, Solomon put a special box called the Ark of the Covenant into the room of gold. The people had put God's Ten Commandments in the box. Wherever the Ark of the Covenant was, God was there too. The people went to the temple every day to worship God. The temple was the most impressive building ever built for God. And God was happy to live in the temple Solomon built. And so here is a picture of Solomon. And maybe that's King David. We don't know who that other person is. And they're looking at the beautiful temple. And there's the special room, all in gold, for where God was going to live. And if you look, this is that special box that was made that kept the Ten Commandments. Remember the stones that Moses got from God way up at Mount Sinai and brought down to the people? Well, those stones are kept in this special box, in that special room that they built for gold for God. Do you find Squiggles? Have you discovered where Squiggles is already? Sure, there he is, right there, looking at the lovely room built for God. Well, deeply loved children of God, we have wonderful buildings as well that people come to worship God. And the Jewish people have temples, and Christians have churches. And right now, here at Emmanuel Lutheran, we're still following COVID CDC rules, which say that we shouldn't be together when we sing and have to social distance. So we're worshiping wherever you are. That's right. You can worship God, praise God, give thanks to God wherever you are. But God does call us together as a community of faith known as the church. And we serve God and we serve neighbors because we worship God as our God, as our leader. And so, people of God, God loves you so much. And we put our trust in God. And so, Mary and Carol and Peter and James and Solomon, God says to you, I love you. Oh, let's on the count of three say, Jesus loves me. Are you ready? One, two, three. Jesus loves me. And we know that we're not the only ones that Jesus loves. Jesus loves the whole wide world. That's a lot of people. So let's on the count of three say, Jesus loves our neighbors too. Ready? One, two, three. Jesus loves our neighbors too. Ah, the amount of love that God has through Jesus for everybody is beyond our imagination. God just loves us so much. So where do you worship God? Where do you go to worship Jesus? Are you worshiping right now in a church? Are you worshiping at home on your computers? Are you worshiping God in the park? Where do you go to worship and give God thanks and praise? Wherever you go, know that God hears you. Yes, God does hear you wherever you are. So, beloved children of God, Maureen, Linda, James, Ron, Harold, Frank, God loves you. So have a grateful day today, and I'll see you tomorrow for another story time with Pastor Maureen. Have a grateful day, everybody. Remember, Jesus loves you and says you are worthy of God's love. Bye-bye, everybody. See you tomorrow.